surprising. We have spotted them in Stierenbach shooting across here, full speed. It's something going on here. Maybe it might send wild dogs, or it could be something that is in the area.
Okay.
Yeah. Loud and clear.
Thanks, so I've just got a question from Valerie. And they just want to know, do they bark or sound like a typical domestic dog? Or do they have a different sound they make? She's talking obviously about the wild dogs. And she says she is very, very happy to see those wild dogs. And everybody is ecstatic. Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much, Mr. Haram. Question come loud and clear. Valerie asking a question whether the wild dog are ducking like a buck. I mean, they bark like a dog. Not really. They made another sound which is very familiar into the area. Like, ooh, ooh, ooh. Very, very low. If I do this, because the wild dogs are very close, they might come into the area. And I don't want to do that because the very, very sense of hearing is very, very good. It's how actually they do the sound. So we have seen a Stierenbock coming across here, but that sign, it shows it could be something into the area that Stierenbock have spotted. Is how they actually make the sound. To go out, it could be something else that the Stierenbock has spotted into the area. Could be a leopard, or never know. Look like wild dogs are still more, a little bit more west. Gary Charles is very far away. Look at the ducks from the road heading north.
Sorry, just one question. If you want to go to Woodhead for about a kilometer, that's the better.
Yeah, try to call Charles on channel. I'll call him on channel 2 for you. Charles, Gabby is calling you on channel 3. As I mentioned, these dogs will take Spam Road. This is Spam Road, and then they'll go, as far as I know, they'll go to quarantine. From Palantino, take your driveway up to the west. So it's, they're doing whatever I said, area. And this road is one that we're taking, hoping maybe they will come here. It's true. The right here. It's amazing. All the time when we follow them here, they like to go inside here, checking here, and go, come back into the road, keep heading into the north. It's very amazing. We now know how the ducks into the area operate, which road they like the most. Remember when we find them one day, the evening scent mark somewhere where they are now. It could be a matter of, they used to scent mark here when they come into the area. As you can see, last time they also headed west and we lost them here, and they even come back to the road. So they like to do whatever they normally to do for them. It's common to do. To do for them. But look like if the head west will have problem, they're doing the same. Look at that. last time they had a strip there. We just want our mouths on the radio, maybe the other guys will come and help us. It's very, very thick here. It's very common for this wild dog to walk off into the road and do the same. We got my dad, she was inside of Shibam Road. We need someone to come and help us there. Yeah? We might get to lose them.
Contact Shibam Road, sending north.
Yeah, affirmative.
Okay, I'm coming.
Look like we're hunting right here. It's very easy to lose wild dog, but let's try. They spotted something here. As you can see, dogs are jumping up and down. They get there, right in the front. Not easy for us here. Dogs are heading towards the moon cut line. We're so far from the road, we're lucky that right in front of us. Just here now. Looks like they're headed down towards the road. Lucky. Last time they went to the same block. But we haven't managed to keep with them. They disappear into the bush. This time it looked like we're trying our best to keep them. Maybe we might be lucky seeing them making a kill, especially if they can go down as far as the quarantine. We all know that there's quite a lot of impala there. Looking forward, seeing them hunting.